Thank you, Jenny. Thank you. Thank you very much indeed. Do that back. David.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Hi, Tim. Thank you. Hi, Brendan. Hi, Julia. Good morning.
Well.
Simon, thank you. Hi, Peter. Thank you. Okay, thank you. Good morning. Thank you. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning, thank you. Hi. Thank you. I'm at the club. Hello, Rachel. Hello, Alex. It's Andrew. Thank you. Hi, Andrew. Thank you. Hi there. Hi. Hi, Sam. Thank you. Hi, Tim. Thank you very much. Good morning, thank you. Hi, Duncan, thank you. Hi, thank you very much. Hi. Good morning, thank you. Thank you. Hi, Helen. Hi there. Hi there. Hi there, Helen. Good morning, thank you. Hi, welcome. Hi, good morning. Hi there. Hi there.
Sugar.
Very good to see you again. Hello, thank you, good day. Hi, Kieran. Yeah, thanks, Kieran. Hi, Henry. Yeah, good to see you. Thank you. Hello, Philip. Yeah, good to meet you. Thank you. Hello, guy. Hi, thank you.
David Witt.
Good, lovely to meet you, David. Hello, Dominic. Good to see you. Hi, nice to meet you.
Welcome back.
Hello, thank you, James. Thank you.
Hello,
what's
your
name? Hi, very nice to meet you. Hi, Christine, thank you. Hi, Vijay, see you.
Tim Sofie.
Oh, hi there, thank you.
Paul Chamberlain.
Nice to meet you, Paul.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
One Martin.
Hello, thank you, Martin. Great to see you, thank you very much.
Howard again.
Hello, Howard, twice. Great to see you. Hello, Philippa, thank you. Good to see you.
Tim Phillips.
Tim, nice to meet you, Tim. Hello, Lyndall. Good to see you. Good to see you, thank you.
Hello, I'm Jeremy Isaac.
Ah, Jeremy, nice to meet
you. I wish you a very good, fulfilling
time
here. Thank
you. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you.
Jonathan Hodgkin.
Very nice to meet you, Jonathan. Nice. Hi there.
Alan Bott.
Hi there, Alan.
I left a book for you within the lodge.
Oh, yeah. Thank you very much. Nice to meet you. Hi.
Peter Phillips,
Peter.
Musician.
Good to meet you, Peter. Okay. Yes.
Adrian Nichols.
Hi, Andrew. Very good to meet you. Thank you. Thank you.
Richard Allen.
Hi, Richard.
Welcome.
Thank you. Hello.
That's right.
Good to see you. Hello, Ben. Hello, Martin. Simon. Very good to see you again. See you. Yeah. Hi. Thank you. Hello, Helen. Good to see you.
Hi. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Hi. Thank you. Hello, Andrew. Good to see you. Thank you.
Congratulations. I'm a visiting research fellow.
Thank you. Good to meet you. Good to meet you.
Simon Shortman. I'm a visiting fellow.
Very nice to meet you.
You too.
Hi there. Hi, Lucy. Good to see you. Yeah. Hey, India. Good to see you.
declare that on the first day of November, in the year of our Lord, 2017, the governing body of the college elected Professor Irene Tracey to be warden of the college from the first day of October, in the year of our Lord, 2019.
I, Irene Tracey, hereby declare that I will faithfully perform the duties of the warden and uphold and obey the statutes, bylaws, and regulations of the college. I install you as warden of the college.
74. In the name of the most glorious and undivided Trinity, the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, Amen. I, Walter de Merton, Clerk and formerly Chancellor of the illustrious Lord, the King of England, trusting in the goodness of the sovereign Creator of the world and of its blessings, and confidently reposing on the grace of Him who at His pleasure orders and directs to good the wills of men. And after I had frequently and anxiously considered how I might make some return in honor of His name for the abundance of His bounty towards me in this life, did formerly and before the troubles which have of late arisen in England, found and establish a house, which I willed and commanded to be named and entitled the House of the Scholars of Merton. This house was founded on my own property, which I had acquired by my own exertions. It was situated at Malden in the county of Surrey, and was destined for the constant support of scholars residing in schools, in behalf of the salvation of my own soul and of the souls of the Lord Henry, formerly King of England, that of his brother, Richard, the renowned King of the Romans, and those of their predecessors and heirs, and of all my own parents and benefactors, to the honor and glory of the Most High. But now that peace is returned to England and our old troubles are allayed, I approve with firm purpose of mind establish and confirm the former grant, and I limit, grant, and assign the local habitation and home of the school to be at Oxford, where there is a prosperous university of students, on my own proper freehold, which abuts upon St. John's Church. And it is my will that it should be called the House of the Scholars of Merton. And I decree that it shall be the residence of the scholars forever. As I had, at the time of the aforesaid troubles, bestowed on the House of the Scholars, who, with the blessing of the Most High, are to reside there for all future times, my manors of Malden and Farley and their appurtenances, for the perpetual support of the scholars and ministers of the altar, who are intended to be resident in the house. Now that the peace of the realm has been again restored, I make the same grant, and approve and deliberately ratify and confirm it of my own free and spontaneous will. It is my further decree that the aforesaid manors shall remain forever in the possession of the scholars and brethren, and so of any other manors which I have acquired or may acquire for their use, under the forms and conditions set down below, and that as well in respect to the persons as to the rules which are to bind them, and which must, God willing, be observed without intermission during all times to come. The house is to have a superior, who is always to be denominated the warden, and who must be of circumspection in spiritual and temporal affairs. The warden is to have the preeminence and authority over all the scholars who reside there, and over the ministers of the altar, and over all the other brethren and managers or bailiffs, or by whatever other name they go, who are appointed to the external or domestic administration and government of the house. And all persons, as well scholars as ministers of the altar, brethren, managers, and bailiffs, are to obey and look up to the warden as their superior.
Thank you. Let us pray. Almighty God and everlasting Father, whose Son Jesus Christ has revealed to us the knowledge of your truth, bless this college, founded by your servant Walter of Merton. By your grace, may it flourish as a house of faith and learning. By your wisdom, may all who study here be guided by your truth and the knowledge of your love. By your Holy Spirit, may all who live and work within these walls be united in bonds of peace and goodwill. And grant to your servant Irene, who this day has been installed as warden of this college, the needful gifts of grace, that she may be strengthened to follow the example of him who came not to be served, but to serve. Even Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be ascribed all might, majesty, dominion, and power, now and forever.
Amen.
Remember, Lord, what you have wrought in us, and not what we deserve. And as you have called us to your service, make us worthy of our calling. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Being made one by the power of the Spirit, let us pray with confidence, as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest upon you and remain with you always.
Amen.
In memoria aeterna erit Justus. Justorum anime in manu Dei sunt. Domine Deus, resurrectio et vita credentium, qui semper es laudandus, tami viventibus, quam in defunctis. Agimus tibi gratias, profundatore nostro, Walter O. de Merton, ceterisque benefactoribus nostris, corum beneficius, hic ad pietatem et studia literarum animor. Rogantes, ut nosis donis ad tuam gloriam recte utentes, una cum illis, ad resurrectionis gloriam immortalem peducamur. Per Christum, Dominum nostrum.
Amen.